Manchester City Morning Show.
A pleasant good morning and welcome to the Sugar City Morning Show. It's a great pleasure without no measure to be back in your company at 2 minutes after 7 o'clock. My name is Dylan Jones and this is the Sugar City Morning Show. Let me say good morning to Emmanuel Martinez.
And good morning and welcome back to you, Dylan.
Thank
and
you I very much, Emmanuel.
That you're feeling much better than the past weeks.
Oh, yes. Well,
it's good to have you back.
Prayers are a wonderful thing.
It's good to have you back.
Thank you. As you were saying, this is the Sugar City Morning Show. For those of you who just joined us, hello and good morning to you in your neck of the woods. No matter where you are, where we're reaching you. Could it be Dangriga, Kayo, South, Father, Deep South, Stan Creek,
Pomona, Mango
Creek, PG, Benke Viejo, Orange Walk Tongue, Orange Walk District, Corozal District and the Villages, Sarteneja, Chunush, Buenos Dias, mi familia in Chunush, the Heredias in Chunush, take it easy, and also, where is Blue Creek, Mango Creek, all kind of creek, Ali Creek, Kala Creek, Yo Creek, Star Creek,
Cricket,
I want you to creek with it. Good morning, good morning. This is the Sugar City Morning Show. We want to remind you that you can reach us at 302-2170 or call us at 302-2170 or text us at 626-5832 or
635-7436
to be a part of this morning's discussion. Once again, we're going to go directly to Emmanuel to start us off, you know, prayer this morning. As you all know that we jump start the morning with a word of prayer and
thank
everything go
much.
Good after that.
Muy buenos días y bienvenidos al Sugar City Morning Show. Como se dieron cuenta, ya esencialmente se han normalizado las cosas aquí con la presencia del señor Dylan Jones. Bienvenidos, Dylan. Un gusto tenerte aquí de vuelta. Pues hoy es el 19 de septiembre, hoy es lunes y el comienzo de una semana nueva. Sin embargo, tenemos a las celebraciones de independencia justo a la mitad de la semana, el miércoles. Así que mañana por la noche, pues todo va a estar bastante alegre y concentrado ahí en el centro del pueblo. Y nuestras oraciones van directamente hacia esas celebraciones, pidiendo, Padre, de que tengamos celebraciones sanas, y que no tengamos violencia, y que no tengamos ninguna pérdida de vida, que por X razones, y que todo pase sin azar, que nos podamos divertir sanamente, que nos podamos divertir sin tener que estar tirando botellas o peleándose con otra persona, pero reconocer cuando estás mal y decir, ¿sabes qué? Lo siento, no tuve razón para hacerte daño o para intentar hacerte daño, mis disculpas. Eso es lo que hace un hombre. Eso. Padre, te doy las gracias por todas tus bendiciones. Te doy las gracias porque hoy yo estoy vivo, hoy camino, hoy vuelo, hoy como. Padre, muchas gracias por esa capacidad. Te doy las gracias también por la buena salud que nos das a todos nosotros. Y las fuerzas para venir a trabajar. Te agradezco todo lo que haces por mis familiares, mis amistades, mis compañeros de trabajo, Padre. Gracias, gracias. Te pedimos, como siempre, para aquellas personas que están pasando por tiempos difíciles, ayúdalos, Padre, consuélalos, confórtalos. Y enséñalos y llévalos hacia donde puedan ellos encontrar la paz y la felicidad, que es simplemente en tu presencia. Padre, te alabamos, te bendecimos, te decimos gracias eternamente. Amén.
Thank you very much, Emmanuel. We have the weather report for this morning. I'll ask Emmanuel to...
Okay, sure. So this is the weather, public weather forecast for today, Monday the 19th of September. And this report generated, folks, at 6 o'clock in the morning indicates that relatively moist and unstable conditions prevail over the area. So it's pretty much the same situation over the past weeks. Relatively moist and unstable situation conditions prevail over the area. The 24-hour forecast, cloudy at times with a few showers and thunderstorms, mainly over southern and coastal areas this morning, inland this afternoon, and in the south tonight. The winds blowing from the east or northeast at 5 to 15 knots. The sea state light chop to choppy. There are no advisories in place.
So the restaurant, they're not in a full sail.
The outlook for Tuesday and Tuesday night is for some cloudy spells with a few showers and isolated thunderstorms, mainly over the southern and inland areas. The temperatures, the highs along the coast for today, 87 degrees, inland 92, and up in the hills, 78 degrees Fahrenheit. Lows for tonight along the coast, 78 degrees Fahrenheit, inland 72, and up in the hills, a cool 67 degrees Fahrenheit. The tides, there will be a high tide at 11:57 this morning, followed by a low tide at 5:40 this evening, followed by a high, another high at 11:53 p.m. tonight, and in turn, that is followed by another low tide at 6:35 tomorrow morning. The sun sets today at 5:51. The sun rises tomorrow at 5:41 in the morning. The sun sets at 8:28 this morning. The moon sets at 8:28, and the moon rises tomorrow, this evening, at 8:30 p.m. And folks, we're transmitting live from Norte Vision Channel 10, and we're being viewed countrywide through a connection with cable networks, Centaur Channel 60, and various other NCN Channel 17, and various other companies that retransmit our signal. We're also simulcasting live through a radio simulcast with Universal Radio. Unfortunately, and for reasons I really don't begin to know and cannot explain, our on-air transmission on Channel 10, which is on-air Channel 10, is not functioning yet. I ask for your apologies and just trust that it's going to be up very soon. So those people who depend on us in the villages, I know we've been getting constant barrage of calls and texts by telephone asking, when is it going to be up? I cannot answer you that question, unfortunately. I'll just have to pass it on to the manager and to Mr. Vega, so they can possibly deal with that situation. But I mention that because I got two or three messages this morning asking, when is it going to be up? Buenos días, compañeros. Este es el reporte del tiempo para hoy, lunes 19 de septiembre. Este reporte generado a las 6 de la mañana indica algo que hemos estado viendo por los últimos días, que son condiciones inestables y húmedas están predominando sobre nuestro país. Y para el pronóstico para las siguientes 24 horas es nublado por momentos con algunos chubascos o tormentas, esencialmente sobre la porción sur del país y sobre áreas costeras por la mañana, en el interior del país de nuevo hoy por la tarde y luego por las áreas del sur hoy por la noche. Los vientos del este-noreste de 5 a 15 nudos. El estado del mar, famosamente ligeramente agitado, ha agitado. No hay ninguna advertencia y se espera que para mañana martes y martes por la noche tengamos periodos de nubosidad con algunos chubascos, tormentas, esencialmente sobre el sur del país y áreas del interior del país. Ojalá y no tengamos lluvias mañana por la noche. No lo creo. Nah. Las temperaturas, las altas por la área costera, 87, en el interior del país, 92 grados y por las colinas, 78 grados. Y las temperaturas en las bajas por la costa, 78, en el interior del país, 72 grados y por las colinas, 67 grados, compañeros. Las mareas a una alta a las 11:57 hoy por la mañana, una baja a las 5:40 por la tarde, otra alta a las 11:53 hoy por la noche y luego la segunda baja a las 6:35 mañana por la mañana. El sol se oculta hoy por la tarde a las 5:51 y el sol sale mañana a las 5:41, mañana martes. Y la luna se oculta a las 8:28, es más, entre 1 hora y 16 minutos, y la luna sale a las 8:30 hoy por la noche. Así que hoy y mañana vamos a tener la luz de la luna reluciente. Le damos las gracias a Forecaster Gordon y nuestros patrocinadores. Como siempre, German Vegan Sons, y Vegas Imports, al honorable ministro Gaspar Vega, Hungry Man Barbecue, Aqualife Water y también Albion's Transportation Company.
And Youth Connection Bank. For booking, call 5-600-5769. It's exactly 13 after 7 o'clock. So we look upon good weather, fairly good weather for the next couple of days, I would say.
Kind of unstable. You really can't tell. You know, at the end of the day, all I say is it's all relative to the month of September. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not like March or April where you know it's not going to rain. September is very erratic. So, and this history is on my side, I tell you. It might be sun in the morning, it might rain in the afternoon. This is typically what happens. Sun in the morning, rain in the afternoon to cool off. And then some drizzles perhaps in at night. But I think that tomorrow, I'm hoping really that it's not going to rain. I'm hoping that it's going to be a beautiful night tomorrow.
Tomorrow, Independence Eve, no?
Yes.
Well, we look forward to that. It's 14 after 7. We take a commercial break. And we will be right back to discuss a little bit about the current situations that's happening in our surroundings and across the country. Once again, we invite you to call us at 302-2170 to be a part of this morning's discussion. We'll be right back.
This September, the Jewel shines as only the Jewel can, with a fabulous mixture of culture, passion, and pride. Things kick off on Saturday, September 3rd, when the National Celebrations Commission brings you the best, brightest, and maddest carnival costumes for the King and Queen competition. Then move to the groove and rhythm of the Steel Orchestra at the Panyard on September 9th. On Saturday, September 10th, we'll commemorate the Battle of St. George's Key by day and see a new Miss Belize universe crowned by night. The celebrations get wild at the Juve on September 17th. Later that day, the streets of the old capital come alive with the colors and hype of the Carnival Road March. Then we lift the flag to the skies on September 20th. And on September 21st, we celebrate 35 years of independence. Sovereign and strong, together as one.
They see you and how you're living. Busta. Always a star, yes. You live in color to the limit. Busta. Large and in charge, yes. That's why you rock with Busta. Busta. Refreshing range of colorful flavors. Always a star, never the audience. You run things, things never run you. Busta. Yes, you are the life of it. Not just a part of it. Your life is never black and white. Live in full color, Busta.
You know your baby is happy when wearing Bebin Pampers. Bebin Pampers. In all sizes. Bebin Pampers. Make your baby happy. Available at German Vega and Sons.
Mr. Briseño claims that he wants to imprison anyone named in immigration wrongdoing.
Once we get into government, we are going to go through this, and anybody that can be held criminally liable, we are going to hold them liable. And if they have to go to jail, they are going to go to jail. Enough is enough.
But even your name is there. I saw for recommending a visa. It's an international person. I can't.
I have
but it's there in the visa one. That's my point. It's in the visa one. I think it's a. I saw it once. I saw it.
I did not. I don't remember ever. Please, so many PH.
Are Johnny and the PUP ready to lead?
Let's get ready to rumble! We'll be right back.
serious. Get bop.
Already a hotspot for commercial activities, entertainment, and recreation, Belize City will have a massive upgrade with the construction of the $30 million Belize City Center multi-purpose facility by the government of Belize.
The idea is that it will be a multi-purpose facility with the emphasis on court sports for the country, but with the ability to branch out, of course, into entertainment and other cultural venues that we would like to see happen within the city of Belize, and to also promote throughout the country of Belize other entertainment.
Upon completion, the facility will have 4,500 individually molded seats, 3 wooden courts, 4 locker rooms, and many other new and exciting amenities for sports and entertainment. The government of Belize is committed to the infrastructural development of not only our cities, but of our country. Your vision, our mission. Says police beat him up during the incident that he caused at the house meeting.
I've gotten beaten up by the police force and someone beat me up that cool and they beat me up.
He even filled out a medical report for the police. But lucky for us, he didn't know what all was caught on tape.
Damn!
Is Julius telling the truth? You be the judge. The Barrow administration has put mechanisms in place to weed out wrongdoing in the immigration department. But let us examine what occurred during the PUP tenure. When in September 22, 1992, the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs was instructed by Syed Musa to write to the Director of Immigration and approve 254 nationality certificates with no oversight, waiving all fees. The certificates bore no photograph of the applicant, and there was no record of swearing in, an oath having been taken. In several other instances, Syed Musa was written to requesting the waiver of the procedures and fees of many persons applying for nationality. They gave away millions of dollars in revenue belonging to the government of Belize.
Welcome back to the Sugar City Morning Show. Again, Dylan Jones here. I'm joined with Emmanuel Martinez. Over the last couple of weeks, Emmanuel, we've been hearing over the media and the airwaves about the different scenarios going on in the country, situations, no? Surrounding people. One of the biggest things right now today is that the teachers are going on a protest demonstration in Belmopan. Today, well, I think they leave Orange Walk at 7 or to be in Belmopan at a certain time. We wish them all the best, the teachers. We hope you have a peaceful demonstration and get back home safe to your family, no? But I would like to say that we have a phone here at like 30221, so we want to hear from people. We want to hear from the parents.
Well, the big question is, Dylan, is how many kids are going to go to, how many teachers are going to go to the demonstration? And the question in the parents' mind is, will the schools be open today? And if you do send your school children to the school, who will take care of them?
Well, the press release from the Ministry of Education, Youth, Sports and Culture saying that there is regular classes today.
Yes.
And school bus will be running as regular schedule today. So by now, parents, like you correctly said that by now, parents must be wondering, if I send me picnic at school, who am watching? What they do? Run on and get in trouble, this, that, so.
And at this point, may I interject? And I'm asking somebody in authority, anybody, who is within, say, because I do know that the schools are being opened by a mandate coming from the Ministry of Education. So if you are perhaps within the at the helm of one of these
institutions,
perhaps maybe the principal or the manager, school manager, kindly call us, please. We're asking you. And tell us, what is the situation at the schools? Will they be open today countrywide, and in particular here in Orange Walk? Well, we know that they will be open. I'm sorry, let me rephrase that. But the point is, how are you going to deal with the situation when kids get there? Will you be able to, if you don't have enough teachers, will you be able to form study groups? Or will you have, that's exactly the kind of thing. Because the parents want to know. And sometimes in the absence of knowledge in this case, they prefer very simply to say, "Ciao, I know I send it. That's good. Can't waste of time." Please call us. I'm asking you to please call us and tell us exactly what's going on.
The general sentiment that the people out there is like, "Damn, man, school just opened," or you know,
it's been like so many 2 weeks. It's maybe the third day. I mean, the third time that there is a suspension of classes.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that above all, teachers, yes, they do have a right to fight for certain things. But above all, I think that it's within, it's a call to conscience.
And one of the things,
call to conscience. What are you there for? To teach or to be a politician?
One of the things that the Prime Minister mentioned, he said that their strike make you wonder if it is, or their protest.
Because there's not a dispute. We don't have a quarrel with
the. I was going to say that he made him wonder if it is legal, because you don't have nothing to do with the labor.
Well, it is legal. They can do whatever. The unions can do that as long as they have that, you know? But,
What the Prime Minister said, I tried to find it. The Prime Minister said that their strike action, it make you wonder if it is legal, because then actions not.
If it's warranted, it would be a better word, perhaps, because at the end of the day, we don't have a dispute as if the government is telling you, no, we're not imperial, you know? And if it was really born, out of this situation where government, if out of a legal dispute, then God damn it, take the streets if you want, demonstrate all you want. But at the end of the day, it's not a legal dispute. And Mr. Luke Palacio has openly said that it's not really all about the 3% increase, that is about good governance. But I think at the end of the day, guys, that it reeks of political intervention. I'll be honest with you, that's the way I see it. That's the way I see it. Because we all know Mr. Luke Palacio is an active PUP politician. We know that he was up in the Punta Gorda. Was it Punta Gorda Town Council?
So I think so.
All right. We do know that well, he has political ambitions, or he had. I don't
this,
know.
This is what I was trying to. Let me just quote the words of the PM.
Yes, go ahead.
So you can understand exactly what I'm going to try to say. He said, right from here, he said, I do stand by my position that, that those issues do not constitute a labor dispute.
That's what I told you.
And there is a whole question of whether the strike legally is justified.
Yeah, it's justified. If it's
justified,
it's legal.
Yeah.
It's legal, but is it justified? If it's warranted, that's the point.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Because you know, they say nothing about labor dispute. You see what happened to Wicked Luke, in my view, no?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we're going to strike for 3%. We're going to make noise. We got to have to give you 3%. So, as educators, you know, people want to say, what? The teacher didn't stand up. But then when the Prime Minister come back and the Prime Minister say, strike for what? Who are you quarrel for? Who said they're not going to give you? We just ask if you're not going to wait. We say, have a meeting with the people, come back and tell you what they say. Not when you come back and say, yeah, we meet the three people and we the strike. We want we three. We this, we that, we the stand down. We the. Then the Prime Minister say, why don't they behave so? Who the quarrel, they don't know. Now when they realize that they're backed against the wall, then they turn the opposition. Oh, we are strike against inquiry in Pastor Luke. We can tell you Pastor Luke jump in a bed of the devil. And when you jump in a bed of the devil, you know, nice. Lot of bad thing happen. Then they talk about what are the next situation? Oh, the auditor's report, auditor general report. So now all of a sudden the union become the watchdog for the politicians.
All of a sudden they turned opposition.
Exactly. Exactly.
All of a sudden they turned PUP.
So now, you know, for the interview, you know, you know, he had nothing again about the 3%, you know.
And even if they were to get it, they would still demonstrate.
Yeah, because
that's my point all the way.
Because the issue now is matters affecting the country of Belize and its people.
Yo no voy a parar aquí a defender a alguien que yo sé que es culpable. Yo lo siento. Yo lo siento. Mejor ni que me lo pida, mejor no lo hago. Pero aquí no estamos hablando de. Y estamos de acuerdo. Y quiero hablar la neta, como dice el grano. Si es que alguien hizo algo malo en el asunto de pasaporte y de visas y eso, pues, como siempre digo, tú eres responsable por tus acciones y al final del día tienes que sufrir las consecuencias de tus acciones. Ese es el modo en que yo lo veo. ¿Ok? Pero que yo sepa que tú hayas hecho algo y me pidas que te encubra, no. No lo voy a hacer. Lo siento. No lo voy a hacer. Pero un punto que te estoy diciendo es simplemente una cosa. Que al final del día, el reporte de la auditora general no hace mención de que el ministro tal y tal y tal es culpable de haber hecho tal y tal y tal. En el primer lugar, no está dentro de su responsabilidad de acusar, pero en segundo lugar, no se encuentra ese tipo de reporte, de palabras en su reporte. ¿Ok? Ahora, simplemente dice porque recomendó. Pues tanto UDP y PUP recomendaron, así que ¿qué es el punto?
Fanjani recomendó.
Exactly.
I don't know if we have a problem with this
line. Y al final del día, yo creo que tanto los medios de comunicación como la oposición tomó ventaja de la incertidumbre dentro del reporte y de la auditora y está tirándole en cara al gobierno diciendo, mira, tantas cosas que están sucediendo. Y en realidad no hay ninguna evidencia de que hubo algo drástico, hasta que se tenga la investigación en el caso. Yo estoy de acuerdo que tenga la investigación. Y estoy de acuerdo que si hiciste mal, fuera. Si te gusta, bien. Si no te gusta, también.
Then again, too, when the other two unions and decide, I say, well, PM, we don't meet with the PM, we don't reason out. So we decide we are. Uh-huh. Wait. Uh-huh.
Pero el punto que estaba diciendo, correcto. El punto que estaba diciendo es que, puchica, tan de repente vemos al BNTU tomando una posición de distinto, una posición que esperamos ver de un partido político y no de una unión que esté poniendo 8 o 10 puntos hasta llamando por tantas cosas y demandando. Pues sí que eso suena como partido político. Es cierto que tienes tú dentro de tus capacidades un derecho, pero You can't hold the government at ransom, man. There's no way you can do that. You understand this?
That was enough for their mind. They could deal with that, no? So now they jump
up. I'm sorry. I just want to address the situation. He says it's about the injustices that we are demonstrating, and they made mention of Faber getting a new vehicle. Well, let me tell you that you don't know if you are aware of the fact that Mr. Faber has been pressured into buying his own vehicle. He is not getting a vehicle from government. How much of a clear?
Can I just pull up something? Yeah, the wonders of how you call it? Emmanuel, technology? Take this call and then I get back to this. Sugar City Morning Show, hello?
Hello, I just calling from the Cayo area, so you're not here. I want to know if you're going to get any classes for the school here.
Cayo, well, as far as I'm concerned, there was no press release saying that there were no classes. They said that there will be regular classes today.
Okay, sir, they will have classes today.
Yes.
As far as I know, the schools will be open, sir.
Yes, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Okay. And we're asking somebody who is in a position, a managerial position, please, to call us and tell us if the kids... And let me tell you something. That if somebody who is in authority can call us and tell us... there's a switch there, I know. If the schools are going to be open, how are you going to treat the situation? That would be very, very...
Just like
very,
you said at the beginning.
Uh-huh. We'd be very, very glad if you did that.
Emmanuel, this NTU, when Luke said that they are a body of their own, independent mm-hmm. to that extent, it is true, and you have to respect that.
Mm-hmm.
But when they want him... straight with the other unions, then they work as one. So I could say, honestly, cuando le conviene. That's because when you check out the BNT union affiliation, it says in order to establish, broaden, and maintain friendly relationship with other trade organization, and related groups at home and abroad, and again to promote and protect its vital interests and those of its members, the BNTU is affiliated to the following organizations. Locally, National Trade Union Congress of Belize, that's the NTUCB, and by extension, the International Confederation of Free Trade Unions. It is in the ICFTU, its international affiliate. So they do have a relation. I'm not going to bind them, but they do have a relation. So he in the play, like, in my view, the big bully. When we need you, if you agree with me. If you don't agree with me, we don't need you. We stand up by ourselves. Why don't you check that out?
Well, essentially, what he's saying is that he's standing his ground.
Mm.
That the Trade Union Congress, the BNTU, I'm sorry, the Belize National Teachers Union, is an entity all on its own, that they have a mind of their own, and they feel that they can fight for cases on their own. Never mind in the past that they have joined together with the PSU in the past, that they have been joined together by other unions in the past in relation to the
issues.
To the issues. But in this case,
this is in
the alone.
This is
so
in
there. Special. There's, you know, a lot of pressure on them to say to answer why uno de by yourself.
This day in the BNTU page, you know, when they have their vision and their mission and their affiliation. So when you get back to the rest, well, we are weird. So you know, convenient him. You know? You know,
like I said,
him.
It's not about the 3% any longer. It's about a political agenda.
So you say if the Prime Minister get in the 3%,
there was still democracy.
There was still
and there's a lot of misinformation that is being propagated out there. Because, you know, I remember calling, and let me see if I can pull it up. Where the Deputy Prime Minister Faber volunteered information that he's getting his own vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Now, I don't know. Mind you, Let me tell you something straight up. I don't know if he was pressured into doing that, just so that people like that individual who texted me a while ago, to avoid that kind of thing. Mm. But I do know. Initially, the prime minister said he didn't think that it was done out of malice or that the prime minister Patrick Farber should suffer the consequences of the of what happened to his vehicle. But at the end of the day, I think that there was a lot of pressure, there was a lot of misinformation from the public saying, say Mr. Farber, something with this and this and the and then throw it, then drive the vehicle, $150,000 vehicle into the sea, gone to hell. Well, I think that public pressure was applied and Minister Farber decided that he was going to buy his own vehicle.
Dude, yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. So I just wanted to clear that up. If it matters to you. You might say there are a number of other things. Well, call me in that respect and tell me that.
So Maria is saying the London demonstration Save Belize went to nowhere. No effects to the masses. So the teachers and Luke had to come to the scene. The teachers are fighting a political fight. Now the money was just a gimmick. We the parents now need to demonstrate against the teachers to give our children a mediocre teaching.
These kind of situations are brought up at the PTA. Bueno, ¿qué pasa con ustedes, maestros? ¿Están aquí para enseñar o están aquí para como políticos?
Well, I know some teachers of La Maclara School, they didn't go to the demonstration.
But that's why I said the class.
They reported the school today.
They report to school, and I know that a number of teachers are reporting to school. So if you have any questions, please. Nadie dijo que no va a haber escuela hoy. Que conste. Let me understood. Nobody said that there's going to be no school, because I heard somebody say, no school tomorrow. So I don't know if they picked it at school. Nobody said that. The schools are open, waiting for your kids to get there. Yes. Nadie dijo ayer, últimamente, de que no haber escuela. Los maestros quizás quieren que tú pienses que no haber escuela, pero la escuela está abierta. Y va a haber cantidad de maestros que están ahí, dándole la bienvenida a tus hijos y están dispuestos a enseñar a tus hijos. Así que no te envuelvas en este rol. Tú mandas a tus hijos a la escuela porque las escuelas están abiertas.
And you know that not all the teachers agree with what they're going on, Emmanuel. So, but because of some I get burned too.
Mm-hmm.
You know. It is the Prime Minister in the news Friday mentioned to a certain extent that you have to be careful because you know how you talk, because you know offend the teachers in no kind of way, you want to keep it, you know. But I don't know, no Prime Minister, and I don't even take it as offense.
I'm sorry for PM.
I don't know PM, but I did tell you.
I think this poor man, if I think that luckily he went bald.
Yeah, no,
because
he had drop off.
Yeah, well, maybe he had drop off. Good Lord, that's even worse scenario.
Because Emmanuel, you see,
he had hair. Emmanuel turned white.
I would imagine that.
No, he had drop off.
I would imagine like Luke Palacio, most of the teachers would have heard this thing now. The opposition, you know, you see an opportunity for. Get out there and make some noise on behalf of the People's United Party. And don't be surprised today at the end of the day when the news come on back, you see Janine and the other, they support them.
Of course he will be out there. He'll be a fool not to.
Why? I don't know. I want to have an appearance.
But then again, he may just not, because he wants it to he wants to maintain the
Passam rule.
But it's convenient for him to be kept abreast of everything that's happening. He wants to know. Let me clarify that point. Yeah.
Well, definitely. So we don't really know how the day will turn out. By now they don't reach Belmopan yet. They're on the way to Belmopan. Can't even reel up last week, then they change their route and they don't want them go up on the house of the National Assembly steps. And I don't know if, I think the last time some the Megara broke up the step and so they try avoiding things and so, right? But
yo simplemente digo, tienes todo el derecho de demostrar.
Y si tú estás
enojado con lo que estás haciendo, ok, eso es tu pensamiento. Yo simplemente estoy dando mi forma de pensar. Todos creemos que tenemos que respetar eso. Pero al final del día, que no tengamos violencia.
Sugar City Morning Show, hello. Hello, good morning.
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Hello.
Good morning. We're asking you that when you call, you lower the volume of your radio or television and speak and listen to us directly through the phone.
Yeah, man, no wait for hear it.
No wait for it to hear it on the radio or the TV, because then there's a delay, okay?
Serious delay, though.
Serious delay.
Serious delay. So, what happened today, Manuel? The question, right?
Well, it says here in Corazon, in Our Lady of Guadalupe, a note of no classes for today was sent last week. I spoke about that last week, Friday.
And no principal had the authority.
Has the authority to do that?
Because they wasn't granted permission.
They were not granted. So, this note,
yeah,
is completely illegal. It's completely wrong. Because no principal or teacher has the right to tell the students that no school on Monday. So, please, the schools are open. Lady of Guadalupe and Corozal, the school is open. I don't pay money to no teacher or principal. Please.
Let me try to find that press release. It say, press release. Minister of Education, Youth, Sports and Culture. I read it for just so I can get reminded. You are aware that the BNT is planned to have a demonstration in Belopan on Monday, September 19, 2016. Please be informed that the position of the Ministry of Education is that schools remain open on Monday in accordance with the Rule 102, Section 4. Your attention is also drawn to Section 187 of 2012 Education Amendment Rule 102, Section 1 to Section 5. These rules clearly outline that rule, responsibility, and management authorities. Please inform principals that they do not have any authority to send notes to parents calling off classes.
Can you repeat that again for the just the last portion?
He say, please be informed that the position of the Ministry of Education is that schools remain open on Monday in accordance with the rule. Rule 102.4. Your attention is also drawn to Section 187 of 212 Education Amendment Rule 102, Section 1 to 5. These rules clearly outline the role and responsibility of managing authorities. Please inform principals that they do not have the authority to send notes to parents calling off classes.
Do not have the authority to send notes to the classes saying that.
To parents.
The parents saying that they won't have any classes. Yeah,
but
so
then do it
completely
well.
Wrong. Okay?
Out
completely
of
out of order. Mm-hmm. El ministerio, el gobierno, el management authority de las escuelas dice, nosotros tenemos las escuelas abiertas. Porque sabemos de que no todos están de acuerdo. Todos los maestros van a ir a demostrar. Así que, y sobre todo, tenemos un derecho de enseñar a nuestros hijos. Y especialmente que está comenzando todavía el año escolar, para que tengamos tanta pérdida de escuela. Es una vergüenza.
So they can't say they never knew, can they remind them? They remind them. You have a text?
¿Nos acusan de lambiscones del gobierno? No, no soy lambiscón. Yo no le amo a nadie.
We did it black and white. This is a memorandum from the Ministry of Education, Youth, Sports and Culture. And it ended by saying, I appeal to you to kindly inform all principals, teachers and parents that Monday, September 19, is a regular school day. School buses will operate as normal. Your usual cooperation in sharing this message is appreciated. Ms. Carol Bob, ED, Chief Education Officer. What more than that, the one? Mm-hmm. You don't have the authority to send home letters to parents saying that they not got no classes. Today was supposed to be, or is, a regular day. A And that's why
hay
some
problema
teachers
también de un maestro que está descontento con lo que estamos diciendo, que no le gusta nada lo que estamos diciendo.
That's why some parents, some teachers who not gone on a strike, protest gone to school today, because it's a regular class day for them, and they reported the school. I don't know, Emmanuel. I don't know where I take for make the teachers them wake up and see where they go on. Because I don't want to ask them no. Only concern about a man hitting.
Get politics out of the trade, out of the union, man.
You know.
The whole problem is when you have political influence in a union. Mm-hmm. And it's guised in such a way. Disguised really in such a way that it would seem to be an inherent plea from the people, from the teachers, when it's disguised by political agenda coming from the president or from the management of the union. And I think this is what is happening in this case.
Okay, I got here, somebody sent me a note from Corozal Community College official. Official. Please be informed that there will be no classes on Monday, September 19th, since the teachers will be going to a BNT demonstration. Students are to report to school on the 20th in their uniform. Students will be dismissed at 1 p.m. on that day. Happy 21st of September.
And that is, where is he that?
See that?
That note is signed by?
You just the heading, the headline, you have the heading of Corozal Community College. Somebody.
No, this is who posted it.
That was sent to me, that's not posted. That's sent to me by WhatsApp, Corozal Community College. So a parent sent it.
All right, can you follow this up and say who signed that note?
It was they sent it, but it was posted for real. Yeah, they sent
it. It was posted but I can't believe that Corozal Community College sent it.
Well, yeah. Then
it indicates that, but there might be something with how it displays on your telephone. But I don't think that Corozal Community College sent that out.
This next one here was. Well, I know. I argue that the thing is that it looked like a note that they sent from the school. So maybe somebody could call us and, you know. I have another one here, Emmanuel. This one was also.
I think it's una lástima que los maestros estén haciendo huelga y estén ganando bien. Si supieran cuántos necesitan trabajo y están en sueldo.
I got an next one here.
¿Es la perspectiva de la gente allá afuera que les está viendo?
An next one here that was posted, it says, mm-hmm. Muffles College High School.
Mm-hmm.
Please note regarding classes tomorrow, parents are asked
tomorrow?
This is, I just read what you say, right? Parents are asked to decide whether they will send students to school. 16 of our 41 member team indicate that they will go to the demonstration. Thanks, God bless.
So 25 will stay. Enough reason to send your kids to school.
These are just information coming in at.
At the hour, yes.
At the hour.
Pues sabe que la gran cantidad de maestros van a quedar aquí en sus trabajos.
And what a time!
Las escuelas están abiertas.
What a time they pick to do this thing when independence, the rate that it can and the even that will look the child of history because. He may put an uproar against the PUP back in the days. No, they know they didn't want to try to do that to the UDP again. But the Prime Minister said, we don't have a perfect government. But I could tell you if you want to talk about corruption, then we have to put a whole new show aside just to talk about the corruption of the PUP. Where they want we forget. What Johnny say, Emmanuel? We don't lose 3 times. The people don't punish you enough. Enough on the punishment. Bring me back in now.
We need to suffer 7 times, 7 times, 7 more.
That's how they see it. When they ask the man your name in the other, you say, who, what, who? Your name, they in the book too. The same damn book owner, they said that once the name in the corrupt.
But my point is, there's nothing wrong if your name is in the book.
But this, what according to them, it is wrong. So now, how when they find out that for their name in the book too? What happened after that? They just start to holler out and start to talk about something else. No? That's how it works. That's how it's set up. It's 7:52. We take a commercial break and we'll be right back with more for you on the Sugar City Morning Show.
Okay.
DigiFans get more, so much more. And when you're a DigiFan with a combo plan, everyone talks free. Free nights, free weekends, more data on the country's largest 4G network, and the best call rates as low as 9 cents a minute. They get more ways to show who they are in more places on more phones. And with the most affordable plans in the country, they get it for less. Be a DigiFan. Get more.
I'm a DigiFan.
I'm a DigiFan.
I'm a DigiFan.
Because I get more.
Because I get more.
Because I get more.
Always more with Digicel.
Expect more, get more. Always more with Digicel.
In January 2014, the Barrow administration improved and strengthened the process for persons wishing to become Belizean citizens by registration. Applications for nationality are now reviewed by the Nationality Scrutinizing Committee, made up of 8 members, including social partners who nominated their own representative for the committee. Names of applicants are gazetted, those approved are signed off on by all members, and forwarded to the minister for signature. The new certificate bears the applicant's photo and a signed oath from the Commissioner of the Supreme Court. The government of Belize remains committed to protecting the integrity of our Belizean patrimony.
Can the accommodation agreement award portion be used to fund government projects? Well, Mr. Man Eamon Courtney, he did say no. Well, make I set the record straight. Out of all the money where the court award for BTL, the biggest amount that for the illegal accommodation agreement when Musa and the PUP they signed. When the government and Ashraf gone to court, the two sides may agree that the money from the accommodation agreement may want put in our charitable trust for fund projects for the Belizean people. But not take my word for it, the director saw in this document we signed, the Telemedia Acquisition Settlement Act. Make a read it for you now. The balance shall be applied in accordance with such requests for grants as the government may reasonably make to fund projects to help the people of Belize. That clear as day. Stop listening to people with their Ashcraft payroll. The record set. Boom!
On Friday, August 26, 2016, one member's behavior brought shame to the entire country.
What is your problem, Mr. Speaker?
They pay you to block me, and that's what they pay you for.
You're going
to
tell me?
You're going to tell me? It's a joke. It's a joke.
Are Julius and the PUP ready to lead?
Sure, but you're asking for rules to be followed elsewhere. You're not following the rules.
You're not following the rules.
When was the last time you got anything free? Well, with Digicel's new improved combo plans, now everyone talks free. With free talk in every plan and even more data for the same low monthly price. I mean, who doesn't love free? Free Sundays with our Lite plan, free weekends with our Plus plan, free nights, weekends, and free calls to your circle with our Elite and Max plans, and even more free 4G data in our Lite, Plus and Elite plans. Don't have a plan? It's easier than ever with low or no deposit for qualifying customers. Still the best plans in the country. Come in and start getting more.
Expect more, get more. Always more with Digicel.
This September, the jewel shines as only the jewel can, with a fabulous mixture of culture, passion, and pride. Things kick off on Saturday, September 3rd, when the National Celebrations Commission brings you the best, brightest, and maddest carnival costumes for the King and Queen competition. Then move to the groove and rhythm of the Steel Orchestra at the Panyad on September 9th. On Saturday, September 10th, we'll commemorate the Battle of St. George's Key by day and see a new Miss Belize Universe crown by night. The celebrations get wild at the Juve on September 17th. Later that day, the streets of the old capital come alive with the colors and hype of the Carnival Road March. Then we lift the flag to the skies on September 20th. And on September 21st, we celebrate 35 years of independence. Sovereign and strong, together as one.
Busta. They see you and how you're living. Busta. Always a star, yes. You live in color to the limit. Busta. Large and in charge, yes. That's why you rock with Busta. Busta. Refreshing range of colorful flavors. Always a star, never the audience. You run things, things never run you. Busta. Yes, you are the life of it. Not just a part of it. Your life is never black and white. Live in full color, Busta.
You know your baby is happy when wearing Bebin Pampers. Bebin Pampers. In all sizes. Bebin Pampers. Make your baby happy. Available at German Vega and Sons.
Mr. Presenio claims that he wants to imprison anyone named in immigration wrongdoing.
Once we get into government, we are going to go through this, and anybody that can be held criminally liable, we are going to hold them liable. Yeah. And if they have to go to jail, yeah. They are going to go to jail. Enough is enough.
But even your name is there. I'm recommending a visa. It's an international person. I can't.
I have
but it's there in the visa one. That's my point. It's in the visa one. I don't remember ever.
Please show me the pitch.
Are Johnny and the PUP ready to lead?
Welcome back to the Sugar City Morning Show. I think we found out just now that the note that I read of Corazon Community College is posted on their web page, right, man?
Yes, it's actually posted on the Facebook page. Mm-hmm. And it marks official. Please be informed that there will be no classes on Monday, September 19th, since the teachers will be going to a BNTU demonstration. Students are asked to report to school on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. That's completely wrong and illegal. We passed
out of order. And they were warned. They were reminded
by this release on Friday not to do that. Unless they were not aware of the release. Mm-hmm. But good Lord, man, this is an open defiance of a Ministry of Education ruling, a government ruling, saying the schools will remain open. Now, I just took, during the break, guys, I just took a quick step out and saw if IT Vet was open and Bishop Martin High School. They're open and schools and the students are going to school.
But the question is, what's going on inside the school?
That's why I asked the people who are in a capacity of management, no, you understand. Mm. Why is it that I made that comment a while ago? Mm-hmm. For parents to be able to feel comforted that or satisfied in their decision of sending their schools, of their kids to school, mm-hmm. rather than a waste of time. So I can tell you quickly that IT Vet right in front of us is open.
Yeah.
The teachers are going to school. We got in
some teachers.
Bishop Martin is also open, and our teachers and students are going to school. Now you parent decide if you want your kid to lose out on his or her education.
But then again like what you just said from the beginning, the question go like this, see? Back and forth, because then if your child go to school and ain't got no teacher to teach, eh? Better keep my home and read a book. Better keep my home and make you read a book or review some notes or do something around the house. You know? because there's no sense. That's why you're correct, you know. A lot of questions. Right now, what time right now? I can see. Exactly. 8-ish. 8 or 2-ish. So, by now, parents know exactly which teacher gone to school and which teacher never gone to school. And mm-hmm. if they are carrying a child at school and left them, so we want to ask you to call us and tell us what's going on at 302-2170. That is the number here to call. And again, I would hope that they, remember they had the so-called peaceful demonstration the other day in the House of, at the front of the National Assembly where they broke the barrier and the police had the bus and shot and that thing. And where turnout of this is that they're saying, oh, it wasn't us, the Christians, it was the people from COLA and other groups. We would hope that they don't interfere in these teachers' demonstration today and just leave them to walk and chant all they want to chant and hope that nothing violent, no tear gas will come on, because then they look real bad on the part of educators of this country, man. They look real, real shallow, real weak that they resolve to that. Luke, again, I tell you, maybe the Prime Minister don't want to tell you because you don't want to offend the teachers, but you got a political agenda. And it's a pity the drag all of the teachers don't, who they follow you, because I don't know all of them they follow you. Some of them got reasonable, good understanding for the reason when they go on. I text here saying, Dylan, sorry, but that is the plan. Maybe, you see? That is a plan to have them behave in that manner today. Well, let's hope not. Ministers and parents, let me get this one. One second. Okay, pull this up. It says here, ministers and parents need to go to the school and see if then would invest half of what the teachers take out of their pockets to keep up with the ministry expectation. Man, listen to me carefully. For those of you who don't know, my wife is a teacher. So you can't tell me about expense when they take out of their pocket for preparing a classroom. And I always complain about that to her, but it apparently falls in a part of their job. We understand it loud and clear. Teachers take out money out of their pocket for preparing a classroom.
Well, I spoke about that last week.
For buying a uniform. Some teachers even go as far as take out money for feed the picnic in a school.
Not only that, but for make them buy paint for painting class. We know that.
You know.
But this is beside the point.
But what I'm saying, Noah, what I want to say is the this is what the union have to look after. I always say the union in the back of the wrong tree. Nothing wrong for them to be concerned. Nothing wrong for any Belizean to be concerned about issues happening in your country. You need to be concerned. But to take these issues at certain levels, why can't, maybe they have an answer for it. I don't know. But why can't the union say MPM, all right, we and wait, but then work with we. Give only ease pan the tax deduction for the time being, no? So the parents and the teachers could catch back some of the money when they understand. Imagine this. Imagine this, Emmanuel. Make I just explain this so this person who texts could understand that we know where they go on. We were hit with a hurricane. Before the hurricane come, man, you see people crowded all people store, all the big store, the hardware store, the plywood, then they go like Johnny Cake off of the shelf. Nail, hammer, people they prepare, people they stack up. You know how, and that's right before school open, you know how much teachers spend early money on that? And when school open, before school open, you're sitting right back to class, they paint, they spend money on posters, billboards, materials, forget the classroom really. Only they know where they find the money again, you know.
We've openly talked about this last week.
Only they know where they find the money again. So we understand where they come from. But because of this, because of this The union need to look into these areas. The union need for us government, maybe PMO could wait, but give him a little ease on the tax for a little while, you know? Because the government could do anything. Maybe they don't set it on the hard for the move, but the government could do what he want. You know, at least, you know, at least a couple of months till we could get this raise and then put it back where they, you know what I mean, Emmanuel? Or here where they go and all the teachers name who they pay their school loan for when they got a UB.
Sometimes I'll go like this. If it took one question, one simple question posed to the teachers to have this thing evolve to what it is now, then you wish you hadn't asked the question. And wonder perhaps what would have been the consequence of not asking, if perhaps we would either not be into this situation, or if perhaps we would have still been in there, but based on a different, what you call it. Sometimes it makes me wonder if perhaps this was just what Luke Palacio was waiting for.
An opportunity to make some noise.
Thank you.
And that's what I'm saying, then the back up the rank tree. If you really have your teachers at heart and you want to help, as the union leader and as a teacher, then you should know the expense a teacher got through. You should know how that dollar should. So we're wrong for make you say, well, PM work with you or something. But no, we're going to strike. We want to demonstrate. PM say no. We want to qualify. We don't qualify. No, we don't have to worry about the race again. We don't worry about the country. We don't worry about the country. Somebody say, I pray to God the POP will not hijack this demonstration. Cola will hijack it, this demonstration, and pray that none of that happen. Well, teachers need to demonstrate to their respective administration of the school, because we, the parents, are burdened with so much fundraising for the school. Again, that is something else to look at. You know, Emmanuel? So, with that I say, I do understand where the person is coming from when they talk about teachers and expense. I do
again,
understand.
We have a confirmation from, it says, from here in Santa Clara, the school is closed from Friday, and the teacher sent out, let me just quickly see this, 1, 3, right, it says, benditos teléfonos viejos. There it is. From Friday, teachers told the children that there will be no classes. So they didn't send a note. So we don't have physical, tangible proof. Because I do believe that some of these teachers will have to suffer the consequences of their actions with the ministry. Okay?
So, Martin, Mr. Palacio is on a political agenda. We all know that already. Teaching is a job, but at the same time, teaching is a vocation, meaning it must come from the heart. Teachers are professionals.
Thank you.
Yes, teachers are professionals. Well, let us hope that, like I said, they have a peaceful demonstration today.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't result in no kind of violence, and hope the PUP or COLA no hijack the demonstration, because that's seems like that is the norm right now, no, Emmanuel.
Mm-hmm.
We could go and take over any demonstration, we could throw some rock.
Just let me tell you, put this in perspective, that this is last year's it says a third raise for teachers and public officers.
Mm-hmm.
This was coming out of the Guardian last year. It says teachers, police officers, firefighters, soldiers and other public officers now know that they will be receiving a third salary increase in as many years, in 3 years, you know? Because, and this is unquote, because we expect continued economic and revenue growth, next year should see a third salary raise for government workers, and this is really quite extraordinary. Prime Minister Dilma announced on the 34th anniversary of Belize independence. Now we know that it was done last year on the 34th anniversary, and we also know that it did not work out the way he said it. Okay? It did not. It did not work out the way, because he says in the, we expect continued economic and revenue growth. Unfortunately.
We expect.
That did not happen. But even worse than that, we had Hurricane Earl.
slowed down everything.
Slowed down just about everything. So, but just let me tell you that the government was in the same, it was willing to do that increase under the framework agreement between the negotiating teams of government and the unions, public service union, BNTU, and the Association of Public Service Senior Managers, signed in February of 2014, one half of the increase in actual recurrent revenue from 1 year to the next year, in a 3 year span, will be allocated to salary increases for public officers and teachers. Based on the formula, ladies and gentlemen, $29 million was allocated to salary increases for fiscal year 2014 to 2015. You think they'll leave it a money in the tax pool? $29 million. Okay? And $38 million for 2015-2016. In fiscal year 2014-2015, the government spent $368 million in personal emoluments and $60 million for pensions. You get that? $368 million for personal emoluments, which is salaries, okay? And $60 million for pensions. Therefore, the $38 million represented an almost 9% salary increase for public officers. When a third race coming to public officers, those in the rest of the region are watching Belize in amazement. And like I said, it's unfortunate.
Sugar City Morning Show, hello.
Technical got class right now. But only beginning at the outside of the door to watch.
Who's that?
Technical?
Yeah, technical, yeah. They open now, but they only beginning outside just look around.
So you could say the school is open, but there's no classes.
Yeah. Right. They got a few teachers who look like they were going to meet inside in the staff room.
Well, it's not 8:30 yet, no?
Yeah.
But we'll just wait.
But college is before 8:30.
It so begins 8 o'clock.
8 o'clock.
Okay. 8 o'clock, right.
Just give them a little break. I'm sure that they will have their meeting and they will determine, this is only to determine what course they're going to take during the day.
All
it's
right.
Obvious. Okay. All right?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Give them some break, some patience. Okay? Let me just quickly finish this. In a time when governments in the Caribbean region are raising taxes, freezing wages, and laying off workers, the government of Belize is getting ready to grant public officers a third straight. Well, we know that we also fell into the same situation as our neighbors, okay? And it's unfortunate, but very simply, a question was asked to the teachers. Can we defer the increase until next year? And it's caused all of this thing.
Somebody say here, Emmanuel said, not to stay on that, but I just want to read this. PUP may have a bus park here by Trial Farm Park, but only about 10 persons got on the bus and none of them are teachers.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Pues ya ven, compañeros. Ya ven, compañeros. O ustedes determinan si es que deben de mandar sus hijos a la escuela. Debo decir que ciertas personas, ciertos colegios han... Vamos a ver.
You got an extra. I try to put this one here together because some people text funny.
He said, like, Macaulay School is closed, and it seems that you are on a political agenda as well, that we are not. Well, I don't have.
When you go on a break, I will find out.
I'm telling you that it says,
yeah, like, but when you go on a break, I'll confirm that.
Okay.
When you go on a break.
Okay.
Say big up to the seventh day. Okay. If the teacher want to talk, why did not go up on the table? Please come on, I can tell you a lot, Dylan. Our teachers are better. We know the teachers are better. We know they say nothing bad against the teacher, but I simply saying that the teachers can't reason out and say that Luke Palacio, they can't don't want
political. But also reason the fact that the Prime Minister acceded to the fact that they're going to have 3% a salary increase. Didn't you all feel good about that, teachers? And in the same spirit that the government was giving you the 3% hike, don't you think that perhaps you all could be a little bit more flexible? in the same spirit. ¿Tú crees que si el gobierno tuviera dinero así tan de repente y no tuviéramos huracán y tanto que hacer, ¿no crees que tuvieras tu dinero, tu incremento? Sí. Y en realidad te valdría madre acerca de todo lo demás, mientras sí. que tengas el dinero. Pero es pretexto.
Big up to the Seventh-day Adventist management. They never part of any demonstration. Also, our children don't lose a day of classes. Good job, Adventist teachers. So, apparently, they never gone. Mm-hmm. They don't got time for that craziness.
Time for waste.
Never got time for that craziness. like I said,
it's strict political issue. And I said on Friday, vamos a ver el tipo de maestro que va a ir el lunes. Ahí se van a distinguir por color político. So said, so done. The political, the PUP teachers are going on demonstration.
Oh, yes.
And they're picking this opportunity to make their voice heard. Okay? All within their rights to do that.
Chapel School, Child Farm, St. Peter's, close. We all know who the principal of Chapel School.
See?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know the Vinny agenda. Mm-hmm. We know St. Peter's, the hello, Johnny Briceño's wife. Mm-hmm. Child Farm. Come on.
You will show your colors. That's what I said.
Come on.
Anticipate this.
I don't want me to say.
Purely politics.
I'll be careful who I call in here because I don't want me to say, then call me, sir. Mr. Checky. You know. New Life and Muffles. Open, Muffles open, New Life Presbyterian. And again, live report from a reporter outside mm-hmm. who is on the grounds. Mm-hmm. New Life and Presbyterian is open. Morris gone out.
You know what I mean? He's out.
So, again, God. We all know what the agenda of the principal at Chapel School. Mm-hmm. You know, John Briceño's wife runs St. Peter's School. And Child Farm Government School is, I can't say yes or no, but it's proceeded to be run by a PUP supporter, according to the street vibes, put it that way, right? But they closed their school today, and I'm hoping that we can get some footages off of these closed gates.
Against a ministry order.
Yeah.
Against a ministry order.
I wonder
if they're willing to accept the consequences of their actions.
I think the education officer need to take a tour.
Y este bocón siempre les dice que tienen que estar listos y responsables para sufrir las consecuencias de tus acciones. Así que piénsalo muy bien. No por tu fervor político vas a hacer de menos tu responsabilidad. Que conste.
I think that the ministry, the education officer, will or should be taking wrongs today and say we're school closed and school
I think that
and give a report.
I think that I trust that they're already outside.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're not out there,
get
believe
out
me,
there.
Get out there.
Well, Miss Carla stayed up at a game, you know. She and his staff they stayed up at a game, you know. So we hope that we get some feedback from that later on, you know, but ourselves will try to see what we can do later, no? We can read this one by this one. Some people quarrel, you know, Chief Manuel?
Yeah, but me not quarrel with them. We have a right.
He said, some people say, we took out the PUP in 2005, now your turn is here. Well, you who won't believe Johnny and forgive him for after the 3 times, well, don't make him lose. Since you claim that you take me out, you who won't put him back in then. Put him back in. Put him back in if you forgive him for all the superabundant so who, all the terrible condition, poverty we're living in because of the people. If you forgive them for that and you find your heart,
and this
if you
I
put
think
them back, go ahead.
That people, because we could delay the talk and catch, but when you begin to understand that the reason why we're short of catches, we have to pay escrow $234 million for $19 million worth of property which the PUP sold, and which essentially is because of the PUP that we had to pay all of this money for BTL. Guys, think about it. The reason you're not going to get paid is because of the PUP corruption, not because of UDP corruption. That's the God's truth. Now, Godwin House went to pains to explain, and I know sometimes you don't want to hear about Godwin House, but mebali. But he was the one who disclosed the fact that so much corruption existed. $234 million in the allocated agreement. And I don't think that we make enough noise about that. But to think that the reason we are in the muddy waters, for lack of a word I would have preferred to use, is because essentially the PUP put us in there. Huh? What about all this super bond? And I know the super bond seems trite and overused, and it seems to be, you know, something that we only pull up conveniently when times are hard. No. This is a living reminder every day that we have to pay over $100 million to super bond against a super bond. And secondly, look at this latest thing. $234 million for an agreement that most assigned. You can imagine where we could have been doing within $234 million.
The teacher's going to get a foot raise.
Huh? Can you imagine?
The teacher's going to get a foot raise.
Guys, put it in perspective, man. Put it in perspective. I'm not to tell you that there is no corruption in government. No country in the world can claim that they don't have corruption in government. None. But it is not as bad as the PUP want you to believe. And that is a fact. And they're trying to pull out of the hat all kind of tricks to make you believe that it is bad. But it's not so, because it depends if two guys in su juego. It depends if you fall in their trick. Because think of it, look at the numbers. Super Bowl, almost $100 million every year. Allocation agreement, $234 million. You know where we could have with $234 million?
$234 million.
You know where we could have to give 30% increase if you ask me.
$234 million.
Which allocation agreement that the PUP caused on us Belizeans.
Roughly $117 million.
And I do believe that it's $234 million.
Jesus lover.
Ponte a pensar. Ponte a pensar.
Sugar City Morning Show, hello.
Hello, buenos días, Gilón.
Yes.
Buenos días.
Es por eso que ves lo que está pasando. Yo quisiera que se firme la ley de anticorrupción, porque ya no vamos a hablar más de esto, porque ellos sí van a tener consecuencias, los que lo violen. Mira, ahorita, no sé si escuchaste la noticia de Guatemala, el hermano de Jimmy Morales, el bocón ese.
El loco, el payaso. ¿Eh?
Ya lo metieron a la cárcel, porque mal usó dinero del pueblo y lo usó para campaña de su hermano. Vaya la noticia. Lo mismo estamos en Belice. Aquí sea PUP o aquí sea UDP. Esa ley de anticorrupción se debía firmar y no tuviéramos ni un problema, el país estuviera avanzando.
I don't want to comment much on that, because believe me, the Prime Minister was talking a little bit on the news the other day, and that thing is not just for signing a paper, you know. Well, luckily,
it has a Dutch call it that it requires of a certified public accountant to do that, where all his finances would be public knowledge to anybody, and you can't really find one who is willing to do that.
So
you know.
So that's what I say.
And then
who condemned the
government itself lends to itself to even more corruption. Why I say you that? Very simply. All right, when you come out of the thing, I'm going to grant you $100,000 to keep your mouth shut. And for los momentos difíciles
que pasan. No, anti-corruption thing, you know.
You know?
Our trap within our trap.
Aye.
Left it so. Left it so, because.
Yes.
You know, so now you could just, you know. Okay, let me just. I get some crazy text right now. It's 27 minutes after the 8 o'clock hour. Say 97% of the teachers from Bishop Martin went to Belmopan on strike. But is the principal there? The principal reported the school. But 97% of teachers gone on strike. So reports are saying about 15 children showed up to classes today. A little handful of students showed up to classes.
What about today? That event?
We're not getting a report from that yet.
Was that right in front of we, man?
We're not getting it yet.
You getting it?
Sugar City, man, show hello.
Yes,
good morning.
Oye, así que estamos hablando de dinero que tenemos que pagar y nadie sabe cuánto tenemos que pagar. Es de Musa que sale en la casa y está preguntando y diciendo que sus hermanos de Dean ganan tanto dinero. ¿Por qué él no le dice a la casa cuánto dinero ganó esa persona que peleó para Ashcroft?
Without the Courtney.
Pues el que peleó para él y es él. ¿Cuántos millones él ganó y quién se lo va a pagar? Eso no lo va a pagar Ashcroft, eso lo vamos a pagar nosotros también de Liceños.
Yeah, because we lost the case, right? Because we lost the case.
Si perdimos la cuestión, entonces Ashcroft no lo va a sacar de su bolsa, sino el Liceño le tiene que pagar todos los millones a él.
Mm-hmm.
Pero Musa no.
Well,
credit message. Why he gets his message was got out his message. Very, very important observation there. Yeah, that's on top of the 200 and how much fat? 34 million? You know? Yeah, the money where your money and collection we got to the teachers, eh, boy.
I don't have anything to say in that regard. I believe that the Yemon is not a politician. And secondly,
Yemon a PUP.
Is not an elected official.
But in a PUP,
he's a PUP.
And in a
but at the end
in
of the
day, PUP where you can't trust. Because he just now win the case, just make so much millions, and then he'll come back and say the Prime Minister make a wrong decision. So how you could trust somebody like that? Then I say people are talking about leave this country.
Yeah, I agree with that. But once he becomes an elected official, then I will speak against him.
Well, we don't ask him to talk against nobody.
Yeah. But yeah, but I have here, I don't know if perhaps... Exactly my point. So why should I talk about the Inbaro's elected officials? Those are private entities.
I'm going to miss the whole point.
All right?
You missed the whole point.
No, I didn't miss it.
You want coordinator and then a PUP, and you can't find a good PUP in this country. you can't find a good PUP. You can find a good PUP in this country. Can you? Can you find a very difficult? We'll take a commercial break, and we'll be right back. It's exactly 8:31. Very difficult, my friend.
Let's get ready to rumble. Get serious. Get bop.
Already a hotspot for commercial activities, entertainment, and recreation, Belize City will have a massive upgrade with the construction of the $30 million Belize City Center multi-purpose facility by the government of Belize.
The idea is that it will be a multi-purpose facility with the emphasis on court sports for the country, but with the ability to branch out, of course, into entertainment and other cultural venues that we would like to see happen within the city of Belize, and to also promote throughout the country of Belize other entertainment.
Upon completion, the facility will have 4,500 individually molded seats, 3 wooden courts, 4 locker rooms, and many other new and exciting amenities for sports and entertainment. The government of Belize is committed to the infrastructural development of not only our cities, but of our country. Your vision, our mission.
Says police beat him up during the incident that he caused at the house meeting.
I've gotten beaten up by the police force. Come on, they beat me up that cool, and they beat me up.
He even filled out a medical report for the police. But lucky for us, he didn't know what all was caught on tape.
Damn!
Is Julius telling the truth? You be the judge. The Barrow administration has put mechanisms in place to weed out wrongdoing in the immigration department. But let us examine what occurred during the PUP tenure. When in September 22, 1992, the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs was instructed by Syed Musa to write to the Director of Immigration and approve 254 nationality certificates with no oversight, waiving all fees. The certificates bore no photograph of the applicant, and there was no record of swearing in, an oath having been taken. In several other instances, Syed Musa was written to, requesting the waiver of the procedures and fees of many persons applying for nationality. They gave away millions of dollars in revenue belonging to the government of Belize.
Digi fans get more, so much more. And when you're a Digi fan with a combo plan, everyone talks free. Free nights, free weekends. More data on the country's largest 4G network, and the best call rates as low as 9 cents a minute. They get more ways to show who they are in more places on more phones. And with the most affordable plans in the country, they get it for less. Be a DigiFan. Get more.
I'm a DigiFan.
I'm a DigiFan.
I'm a DigiFan.
Because I get more.
Because I get more.
Because I get more.
Always more with Digicel.
Expect more, get more. Always more with Digicel.
In January 2014, the Barrow administration improved and strengthened the process for persons wishing to become Belizean citizens by registration. Applications for nationality are now reviewed by the Nationality Scrutinizing Committee, made up of 8 members, including social partners who nominated their own representative for the committee. Names of applicants are gazetted, those approved are signed off on by all members, and forwarded to the minister for signature. The new certificate bears the applicant's photo and a signed oath from the Commissioner of the Supreme Court. The government of Belize remains committed to protecting the integrity of our Belizean patrimony.
Welcome back to the Sugar City Morning Show. The time is 8:36. That's exactly 25 minutes ish away from 24, 25-ish away from 9. We wanna
precise, you know. Is either 24 or 25?
Ish.
No. Ish. That is
still. We are Creole.
No.
We are Creole. I say we are Creole.
As if that was any justification to being perfect.
We are Creole. Ish. We want to say this morning we were supposed to have Mr. Selwyn Tillett from the Orange Oak Police Department here with us, but because of circumstances beyond his control, he won't be able to join us today. He sent his apology.
Mm-hmm.
I just received a message, and he sends his apology, but he will be joining us tomorrow morning.
Okay.
tomorrow at 28. I don't know, tomorrow Independence Eve, what we're going to do? We're going to play music and party, or we're going to talk about what happened today? A hungry man will come up tomorrow. I don't like take bad things for laugh, man. I want to see you. Anyway, football match was played over the weekend. I think
Emmanuel got a report. This is in regards to the, you know, there are certain things I just won't comment.
The Vegas Cup tournament.
This is the Vegas Cup tournament.
Go ahead, sir.
And thank you very much. This is the report coming to us about the games that were played yesterday. And these games were supposed to have been played at the Blackwater football field. Thank you very much.
That's the Gaspar Vega football field. No, say Blackwater can get offended. They call it the Gaspar Vega football field.
Now, at 9 o'clock, the game was played between United Ballers versus White Eagles. It turned out that United Ballers won 4-1. One was an out to goal, two by Raheem Egan, and one by Kadir Galindo, and that was for United Ballers. And one was for White Eagles was scored by Martin Francisco. At 11 o'clock, guys, it was Old School versus San Jose Earthquake. It was 4-2 in favor of Old School. And one was scored by Tyrone Baptiste for Old School, and three by Oliver Hendricks. And for San Jose Earthquake, two were scored by Victor Ruiz. And Victor and Oliver, congratulations. You all did very well. Well, of course, Tyrone as well. And at 1 p.m., you had San Antonio Sinbad versus San Juan Football Club. And it was a 1-0 in favor of San Antonio Sinbad, which was scored by Rubini Carrillo. Then at 3 p.m., we had Trial Farm Herbalife versus Trial Farm Untouchables. And it was a 2-0 score in favor of Trial Farm Herbalife. And those two goals were scored by Edwani Munoz. Congratulations. And at 5 p.m., the last game was between Douglas Galaxy versus San Luis. Again, the game didn't conclude due to electric problem. But 65 minutes of it was played. Our apology in that regard. I cannot give you a finite answer as to how it's going to be dealt with. I hope that the authorities there, or maybe Luis or somebody, can call us during the course of today's show or tomorrow's show to give us some sort of idea of how that will be dealt with or is being currently dealt with. So that is the report coming from the Vegas Cup. And it's religiously every Sunday, as a form of involvement for youths and as a form of entertainment for the people from the Orange Walk District.
So we don't have the schedule for this week yet?
Not yet. I think that it will be coming to us sometime later during the course of the week.
Thank you for that, Emmanuel. And we want to remind you that this Vegas Cup tournament is sponsored by Honorable Gaspar Vega, representative for Orange Walk North. And he has been doing this for the last 10 years or so. So it's getting stronger and stronger every year. He said the lunch and marriage class is, school is open. I just come from there. Please say it, Dylan. A lot of kids come to my house. And they won't go to school. Well, when they go to your house, send in a school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, send in a school. Easy as A, B, C.
So we have schools like Immaculata that pretty much everybody, all the teachers.
Yeah, I said I was going to check. Let me just send off a text. Go ahead, I'll send off a text and just find out.
No, but I was asking you, have you gave a report about Immaculata?
Then teachers gone to strike. Uh-huh.
They went about.
Yeah. Not all of them.
Not all.
Not all of them, you know?
Not all of them. So what happens is that We have also schools like Bishop Martin, where the majority of teachers went to the demonstration. We also have schools in Champaign, like Champaign Ridge, and ITVET is open. At the end of the day, it's working out exactly what the way I figured, that it was going to be along political lines that the attendance was going to be held. Did you get any new information, Dylan?
I'm working on that as
you're working on that
as
okay.
I speak. All right. Just let me send it off quickly and then jump back for your saddle. Okay.
Well, apologies again. I don't know what happened. I guess I'll have to...
Tell me put on Universal Radio, man.
Put on Universal Radio, but Channel 10 on air is not working, guys. At the end of the day, we can't tell you when it's going to be back on the line. I can't tell you when it's going to be back online.
For Channel 10.
Oh my God! Did I confuse that
yes,
report?
Yes, you did.
I did.
Yes,
but that's
did.
The one that I got from.
I think you got the. You read the wrong one, sir.
All right. Did I read out the wrong one?
Yeah. So.
Oh good Lord! My apologies there. Well, it still report was.
Read that one, man.
This is when at the back of it in a computer, telephone here, and everything turns. Que se prende ese botoncito, que se prende ese y se prende el otro. Mm. And,
se lee la gran cosa.
Y estamos propensos. I just want to... Just let me quickly do something here. Si me permites, por favor. So, talk to me about what report you have with you, Dylan. Whilst I pull this up.
Okay, so... Lima Clara School only about two teachers show up along with the school wardens them, and about maybe 10 children, but the school open.
10 children? Yeah. Lima Clara School?
Yes, only two teachers show up along with the wardens.
Ooh.
And
but is the school open?
The school open, yes, the class is open.
Okay.
But only about 10. Well, I don't know if all the classes open, but the school is open. You know? San Esteban doesn't have class.
El que firmó el note o al líder de Guadalupe fue Emmanuel González. El principal, él firmó que no había clases. Pues yo le quiero decir antemano de que él está en problemas. Pero entre el ministerio con él, yo no simplemente estoy hablando en contexto de
the release.
Okay.
He says San Esteban does not have classes. The principal said she's not going to close school, but 11 teachers will not be there.
Oh.
We should find out how much teachers there are right there, no?
Okay, vamos a... Quiero pedir disculpas acerca... Es que me envían mensaje tras mensaje tras mensaje. Resulta que leí el reporte incorrecto del fútbol. Pero les quiero decir que sobre todo...
That's the one.
Blackwater Football Field. Okay.
You are reader?
Yeah.
For this week?
Yeah, at 9 a.m. Child Farm, One Love versus Child Farm Herbalife. One score, it went in favor of Child Farm Herbalife. One was scored by Evan Reynolds. At 11 o'clock, you had San Luis versus San Antonio Sinbad, and San Antonio Sinbad won that by 8-3 over San Luis. E3, now I'm bossing, if you ask me. And four by Juan Chi, one by Rojal Jones, one by Dennis Esquivel, and one by Irvin Cardenas. And at 3 p.m., you had Trial Farm Untouchables versus United Ballers. Again, it was an 8-3 match. And 3-8 was called 1-4 by Jeffrey Herrera, and one by Edmund Reed, one by Khalid Galindo, and one by Yanel Williams. And for Trafalgar, untouchables two from Luis Molina, Ian Chi. And previously, the San Luis, one was scored by Jose Giron, one by Giovanni Marin, and one by Martin Novello. At 3 p.m., San Juan Football Club, it was a 2-2. It was a draw between San Juan versus Trial Farm, and Freddie Grijalva Jr., Miguel O, that's the Trial Farm, and San Juan Edwin Lorenzo and Eliezer Itza. And at 5 p.m., Trial Farm White Eagles versus Barrio Boys. So we have that situation at 5 p.m. And again, our apologies for, my apologies really for...
You never read the wrong one, you just read the last week report. Right?
Put it
anywhere on the wall. It's San Jose School is open. Teachers are in school. Douglas is open too. I'm trying to ask them, I had returned a question to them and asking how many teachers are in school, but for now we know San Jose School.
Why do you
open.
Think that Salah Immaculata pretty much had a high incidence of them of teachers going to the demonstration?
But I don't know.
Yeah?
Wait, no, hold on. I know the piano. I should read this. I can get this. Only 11.
Then I'm going to go back with the same question.
Yes, right now. I don't mind asking.
You can't get away from us, France.
Hold on, let's not read this. Only 11 teachers are here in San Esteban. The principal said, use your criteria. The 11 teachers will not be there, but she said she's not closing the school. Well, if the only 11 teacher and she make 12 and no teacher no go to school, I don't know. I mean, I put all the picnic on the Haman Street at San Esteban for sing
and sing
Baya Condos, Baya Condos, Baya.
Sorry to make joke about this thing, man, but
bad thing for laugh,
like take serious wicked, thing make laugh.
Diaz took my child this morning to your quick preschool and it is closed. You were asking?
Why do you think that Lima Clara had such a high incidence of demonstrators, teachers?
Boy, good question. I know. I really wouldn't know. I mean, I don't know. Maybe then the Father Luke and crazy this.
I would believe so
too. You know, like I say, I mean, call a spade or a spade. I wouldn't want to break it down like what I have in the back of my head. But maybe then the Father Luke and craziness. The orange rock we live in, and if you don't know your neighbor, you don't live here. You are reading between the lines?
Yes.
Alright, yes. Good. So, somebody said become most and then a PUB. Why don't you try to set me up?
That's the way I don't want to tell you, but over the weeks I've learned to be very, very, very outspoken. You know?
Yeah, I said, somebody just text you and say, please tell Emmanuel that Moses and then a PUB.
He
said, please tell Emmanuel that Moses and then a PUB.
Gracias, thank you.
Yeah. The way how the system set up. You know, I mean, like I said, I would say it like this: if you don't know your neighbor, you don't live the orange rock.
Mm-hmm.
And if Creole say, if they're not so, they're nearly so. What puzzled me is now to see that all of a sudden, like we said, the BNT, you know, look at that watchdog for the government. I mean, but you know what I think we got me kind of on the edge too? I mean, how we not hear nothing far for we ministers, eh?
Ooh.
On the real side, I mean, we have a representative.
You just realize that I have been saying that for days.
You know,
we the right to defend and defend and defend. How come we don't? Yeah, hello, volunteer, come here, come up and say I want to talk about this thing because, you know,
temporary school. open the loan. Then he had somebody just text me and said that one sheep on the crazy TV over there. They highlighted people, not send your picnic in at school because you need to support the teachers. She don't graduate, you know. You understand me? She don't graduate. She don't depend on payroll. If you want a picnic, get on the payroll, then you go to school. Teachers in the land, the picnic have for land. The way how look and they look, then they behave that they don't have no regards to no kind of authority. Can they remind me? No close school, no send no letter. Most of them did contrary to that. Send no letter. But no, they got no classes to them. Send the letter.
Unfortunately, I don't know if Sidi Vernon is open or has school. I really wouldn't know. Where is Sidi Vernon?
Sidi Vernon is not Belize City?
Yes. You see, you're getting all of these messages. Okay. But unfortunately, we don't know. I would, like I said, at this point, we're faced with different situations. We're faced with situations where some schools have opened, and responsibly so, because there was a government, there was a ministry mandate saying that the schools must not be closed.
Let's take this call. Sugar City Morning Show, hello.
Buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
Estoy hablando acá de San Pablo, Arcee.
Dígame.
Ajá.
Se fueron los niños a la escuela y está cerrado.
San Pablo.
Ajá. Ok, háblenos, háblenos, diga.
Ajá, San Pablo, Arcee.
Está cerrada la escuela, no hay clases.
No hay clases, pero la segunda principal estaba en el office y los mandó a sus casas que se vayan porque no va a haber clase hoy hasta mañana.
Debieron haber pedido que le escriba una nota a ver si se atreve a hacerlo, porque ya viene...
No, para su casa.
Ok, muy bien, señora, gracias. Que ella sufra las consecuencias.
Bien.
Muy bien, gracias.
Well, again, too, if you're the vice principal and the whole school, they show up and I don't got no teacher, me can't teach all of them.
Mm-hmm. Like I said, put them for sitting on the Haman Street and make them read something.
Emmanuel, you start the show this morning with the right rhythm. So, where are they? Got a school, no teacher. Got a school, no class open. What were they do? Left the picnic and no teacher. What were they do? That, you know, one teacher for 50 picnic, that 22, 3 classes, that could work. Lot of questions, boy. But I think Maurice Garner been upon behind the teachers there. And hopefully, I don't think we're going to get no report for now before the show close. Cause we got 5 minutes, but we'll find out, no? And you're not getting nothing live on the Facebook feed with the bell.
Well, actually, I've not been even watching my telephones. Can't even tell you.
Well, we got 5 minutes, Emmanuel. We're at the eve of the 20th, no?
Yes.
And the celebration, they come up. Let me see the carnival over the weekend. Everything, when they got smooth, tell gunshots start to fire in the air.
I never see the carnival. I'll be honest.
Gunshot the fire by EPR, but we understand that it was...
By where?
EPR.
EPR? Why? But it was not fired at the revelers.
No. I tell you right now what the news is. I'm going to take this call. Sugar City Morning Show, hello?
Yes, Elon.
Yeah.
The man with the truck boat where he get that big money for Ashcraft. But the same man where he pack on 3.5 something million dollars for social security where he claim investing at the... Not
in
your
hand.
I no receipt now, nothing.
Oh.
Remember the court may order that you could pay back that money and lease that right after and not need it?
Yeah,
but
yeah.
The same man, I see it, we notice that they same one they get rich and the poor class of people, but they get nothing.
But then they blame the people.
Then
they blame the UDP?
Carib. 88 profit of Carib. Where that spend? Who get out for it? Mm-hmm. But the money disappear. Nobody know they have, the Belizean people have to pay for it. This is the way the people have to remember. Bye.
Mm-hmm. That's what I said.
But that's what I mean. I said, Manuel, if you could find one good PUP.
That's what I said a while ago when you said, remember that? Yeah. That was the beginning of it. I'm glad that the caller mentioned that.
Yeah, so.
You have to.
They get their jump. Someone has social security money, boy. Rough, and they still eat. I was saying, we don't lose any trade.
Pick something else.
28th, the parade, the carnival in Belize. 1 second. Sugar City Morning Show, hello.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning. Yes, good morning. Go ahead on here.
Okay. I really appreciate as to what the teachers are doing. I get along with the teachers because, you know, we want good governance and we want to see a better Belize, a better country. I really appreciate it. And I appreciate it.
Okay. No, we're listening to you. Go ahead. Hello.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Everybody has a right to cast their opinion.
And what happened is that the relay caught up with him and he
you were talking about the carnival.
Yeah. Why? Anyway, I left him. The carnival. So apparently, a group of guys started fighting with one fella, throwing battle at him, and apparently they were coming towards him, and he took out his license firearm and shoot some shots in the air, you know, to make them back down. And then, you know, once you're in a crowd, a palomita bus, a time for run.
Well,
people are run.
I understand that.
So, how
was the spirit?
No, boy, the carnival was nice.
Really?
Nice. Watch it, enjoy it on the television. Enjoy sitting at home watching it.
Sugar. Okay,
hello, good morning.
Yes, good morning.
Yeah.
I just want to call and ask the people whether to support teachers or anything. Is the teacher a political party or they are a union?
What do you think?
Why are they putting so much demand and they are not a political party? What about the people who are supportive of politics? And nothing to do with politics and Turkey and anything.
What do you think they're a political party?
They're like a more political party and not a union.
Right.
That's what I think. And then you got the general example of corruption. That's what you lost. Who they pa, right? That spent with the budget money
with drugs money when you were in government. Bank of the United Nations. So I don't know where the top of corruption is. Who was corrupted part of this country, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, a little bit of that. Take your time, brother. Don't make your pressure go up because
you're
drop down. Emmanuel, it's
9 o'clock. Yes, it is.
So. We get out of here?
Yes, we get out of here.
Coffee break?
No.
We'll be back tomorrow, and we want to thank you all for calling and sending your texts.
I just want to have a little note, a minute here. Yo no quiero que tengan la impresión de que somos aquí una taja de lambiscones que defendemos ciegamente cualquier acción del gobierno. Eso no es cierto. Eso no es cierto. Y se dan cuenta claramente que lo que hemos estado hablando es acerca de la influencia política que está tan abiertamente obvio en la decisión de la Unión de Maestros.
Can you take this call?
Ya, se mojó el tren. Pero eso es el problema. Es cierto de que los maestros tienen toda la responsabilidad de no solo enseñar, pero también como ciudadanos tienen una cierta derecho, como cualquier otro, igual que yo, igual que Dylan, igual que los demás, tenemos un derecho. Pero tienen la gran capacidad de lo que es solidaridad en unión. Mm-hmm. And that's a union, que les da una voz mucho más fuerte, que por simplemente estar unidos, tienen
pues,
entonces la capacidad.
Ahorita no hay solidaridad.
De poder.
Entre las uniones.
De poder llevar a cabo una voz mucho más fuerte que si estuvieran solos.
Ahorita no hay solidaridad, porque okay. Él dice que es una right. Unión independiente.
La cosa es de que la gente se pregunta, bueno, ¿y qué es la responsabilidad primordial del maestro? ¿Es de enseñar a los niños o es de ser político? Ir a demostrar. ¿Ok? Y uno dice, ah, pero tienen derecho a demostrar porque necesitamos buen... Pues deja que los partidos políticos hagan eso, yo creo.
You got the Green Party. You okay. got the PUP.
Ok. Pero cuando tú, como maestro, te unes a los esfuerzos de un partido político, cuando es obvio que son tus intenciones, entonces ahí es cuando tenemos el problema. Y no me diga, hables acerca de corrupción y robancía de dinero de esto y del otro, y que el PUP es una opción. Porque el PUP escribió el libro en corrupción. Punto. Punto.
Malignant Chuma.
Y simplemente te estoy poniendo la situación, yo, de que si no hubiéramos tenido que pagar tanto dinero para ese famoso allocation agreement de BTL, hubieras tenido tu 3% y ni nada de rollo. Y te caes la boca. Y también Luke se cae la boca.
Yeah.
Simplemente. Pero, porque no te ha entrado, no has logrado ver de que tenemos 234 million dólares que pagar por el mismo PUP, por yeah. quien estás ahorita al lado, entonces ponte a pensar, individuo.
You struck a very good note there, because the least you could have heard from Luke, then, you don't hear nothing about that, Emmanuel.
Ponte a pensar.
Nothing about that, you don't hear nothing about that.
De que la gran cantidad de dinero se fue con pagar el chanchullo del PUP.
Let us
Eso
take this
es la razón.
Sugar City Morning Show, hello.
Yes, hello, good morning.
Morning. Go ahead, Carla.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead, Carla, you're on the air.
Okay, good. I kind of a little bit disagree on that gentleman over there. He said the PUP is corrupt, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I don't believe that. You see, it's not the PUP that is corrupt, nor the UDP that is corrupt. The UDP is the people and the PUP is the people. It's not the PUP corrupt, nor the UDP corrupt. It is only one or two individuals that is corrupt. It's only the leader. So we have to change the leaders then. Musa corrupt and Dean Barrow corrupt.
No. Hold on.
The PUP nor the UDP.
No.
The leader.
I don't allow you to say that Dean Barrow corrupt because it's all craziness. Hello?
Okay.
You're the talk
okay,
craziness. You could have never compared Dean Barrow to Said Musa. You can't say that Dean Barrow signed for any super bond. You see Dean Barrow sell any airport. Dean Barrow never sell BTL. Dean Barrow never signed no
allocation agreement. If you would only know how much money Dean Barrow don't spend already.
You know, if you know, you tell me then. If you know, you tell me.
Uh-huh.
If you know, you tell me. You know how much money he does spend?
We soon find out. We have to investigate first.
Can I ask you a question? Where do you live?
I live in Punta Gorda.
All right, Punta Gorda. Has Punta Gorda seen any changes under the UDP administration?
No, I don't.
Well, you don't live in PG.
Because
you don't live in PG, boss.
There is nothing happening in PG because Dean Barrow is a political man. He deals with politics.
You know, leave that PG, boss, because I could tell you from where I sit down right here, all the wonderful things that PG get under this Dean Barrow government. The road to Halakte. Huh? You want to make a start?
That is an international fund.
What do you mean? But the money spent.
He not do nothing with his money.
How you know Dean Barrow would do with his salary what he want with his salary, man? Come on, how long PUP never run things at PG? I would never even have light.
We got light.
Under the UDP?
No. Under the PUP we got light. But let me speak on that. It is not...
You know, let me get some water, so you're just the idea of running water? How much land Gaspar Vega as the Minister of Natural Resources back then give to the people at PG? How much titles? I ask you a question. How much titles have the people in PG got under the UDP? You are talking about they don't do nothing for the you must be fair, man. Musa, that was a thief, that was a crook, that was a gangster, everybody know that. You can't say Dean Barado craziness. You can't, boss. You could tell me that the Musa sell BTL to Ashcraft and once well sell it again for dollar. You can't say Dean Barrow sell it. You could say Dean Barrow get it back for the people because Dean Barrow you call me away from PG at a cheaper rate.
You said for the people I know benefit not for BTL, we not anyone.
You call me
maybe Dean attorney or Dean brother or Dean family again, but me not get. You have PUB,
man. I respect you for that.
Thank you very much. Very fine job. I appreciate it and I like it. Continue the good work.
Yeah man. Thank you. You see what happened?
Have a good Independence Day celebration.
Yeah, PUP support. When you hear them want to call and talk about them, the two parties are the same thing.
I don't think this, that.
Not come with your crazy. You could never brainwash them, boy. But you can't continue about my prime minister corrupted because you will damn know. To the depths of your soul and the bottom of your heart and your mind, your Dean Barrow.
When I talk, I don't mince my words. I tell you straight up.
Straight up what you want. Let us say, I listen to the money man. But I know I sit down here and make the, Dean Barrow. No. Compare Dean Barrow to Said Musa at all.
And I stand by what I said. Me no care if you agree or don't agree.
You know, so. But anyway, I'm best my friend.
9 minutes after 9 o'clock, guys.
So fast, just now. It's 9 o'clock. Rick, on the next
what car. What yesterday, boy?
80-something.
85, I got it.
I didn't know, but I buy 40, so I lose.
85, I could never win that.
Sugar City Morning Show, hello.
The man who happened that car, I just don't look like he never gone to school or he blind like the Berlin Unit, you know, where he can't see.
Yeah.
The man don't live at PG, man. He lives somewhere. You can't see the Halakter Road. This water system gone up. PG, Patrick open
a
school at PG.
There's a thing called convenience. You view things your way because it propagates your own political view, okay? However, it is important that you watch who you communicate that political propaganda to, because a lot of people will be better versed than you and will know more about the situation than you. So, unfortunately, whenever you give me all the generalizations like that, believe me,
You're not in jail.
You're not in jail.
Yeah, just like, you know, you can't call me and tell me
all my punk free prime minister. If we never had so much big bill for pay for the PUP, if we never had accommodation agreement, if we never had so much.
Things are gonna happen.
Things may happen and they roll. I just, rather than going to protest against the current government, why never protest
against the PUP? To bring back the million?
To bring back the millions.
To bring back the million?
That would have been more in order.
Bring back the millions.
That would have been more
Johnny Calfa.
All right.
That Johnny Calfa for it.
Unfortunately, they say as a government, the longer it is a party is in government, the more unpopular. I think that it's all relative. And it may become even more unpopular. Because the media houses and the political, the opposition become stronger and stronger. And obviously, if there is any corruption, it becomes more entrenched. Mm-hmm. Straight up. But I'm just trying to say very simply, I think that there are some serious efforts from the United Democratic Party government to try to get this thing in order, the financial situation. serious efforts. And I'm hoping, and all are about the Petro-Carib money. The Petro-Carib money, there is tangible proof of how it was spent.
In the way they free us, good roads,
tangible
sidewalks,
proof of how it was spent.
Infrastructure.
Okay. Tangible proof. Not like the Super Bowl money where we're left with your eye open and say, no necesito gastar todo este dinero. Okay?
The Super Bowl money, I mean, so much in money right now, I still try to figure out how much zeros got behind it. Was that about months last year when we started the show?
And the UPOP is trying very hard to convince the people that the UDP government is corrupt and even more corrupt than them. Well,
That's a tall order.
And some people believe it because of lack of information.
No. They know they went and they play the bloody fool.
No, but some people fall. Some people fall for it because of lack of information.
The one they were believing.
Later said, POP said, really?
The one they were going and believe it, that the POP, they were the hope for get back in the power one day. That the one that we hope for changing the vehicle and the driver in 2004.
And finally,
they want upgrade, bad, and things rough.
Quiero decir de que, ojalá, poniendo toda la política al lado, ojalá, compañeros, de que nuestros hijos, hablando colectivamente, no sufran las consecuencias de nuestras ambiciones políticas. Al fin del día, está bien. Pero que sea el final y que todo resuma bien de nuevo mañana en las escuelas. Y que los maestros hagan esfuerzo de tratar de catch up con esto. Porque hay un currículo y eso se tiene que llevar a cabo. ¿Am I right?
Yep. Well, with that, we're gonna leave, ¿no?
Yes.
Okay. I just want to say good morning to Miss G looking at us and enjoying the show. Good morning, Miss G. Trust that everything is okay. Up already and moving to the house.
Oh, they haven't mentioned Nanda que yo comí el tamal el viernes, the CNLs.
Who? I missed that.
Limpia tu baba.
I missed that.
Limpia tu baba.
Who?
Nos mandaron Hunger tamales man? The CNLs.
Oh, CNL, okay.
Okay. Y comimos meat pies y tuvimos fiesta aquí el viernes y te lo fallaste.
That's all right, man. I'm on a little
agradezco los esfuerzos.
Slow down right now.
Limpia tu baba, te lo digo de nuevo.
That's okay, my friend.
Okay. CNL.
If I tell you something you won't believe,
yes.
Mine was delivered at home. Yeah. CNL delivered mine at home.
And did you eat it?
Yes, I did. CNL right at the corner there by under the bus stop.
All right, then I'm glad that they did.
But they delivered.
So that means that
they delivered it at home.
Okay, and me, which means very simply that you can join with me. You can join with me in saying very simply that the tamales were very good. Okay, I like the fact that it had a big leg, chicken leg. Mm-hmm. And then it was moist and juicy inside.
Okay. We have a last call for this morning. Let's take this call.
Oh, yes.
Sugar City Morning Show, hello.
Yes, man. MPP like that for corruption. And then got a degree, then a master's of corruption.
Thank you. We love that. I love that.
I want to remind you that it's not too late to get your September celebration shirt. Could we get one of the shirts in here from Raul from...
it's already coming up.
The September celebration shirt and going at very good price. Here we go. This is a beautiful September shirt. You could buy it and send it for your family in the States. We're more patriotic now. We can't when they will live as is other than the member Belize. But you know. You see? What you say? Sovereign and strong.
Oh, by the way, you don't have to get a triple XL, XL like this one. All right?
Different size.
You get them
kids.
Different sizes.
They got kids.
Medium and so
yeah,
forth.
Yeah, here we go.
When?
It was a 10th day of 21st.
You have the wrong car. You have the wrong song.
The wrong song?
Yes, you have the wrong song.
Independence Day.
No, neither that one. Neither that one.
Ouchan. Wait.
Come on.
Wait. You see, stop me from singing. I can't sing this song anyway. We got to get out of here.
Land of the free by the Carib Sea.
You must stand up when you sing this. We got to get out of here. We say thanks for all the calls. Tomorrow we continue. We'll be joined by Mr. Selwyn Tillett tomorrow. Again, have a wonderful day. Trust everything. Miss G, you could get your T-shirt, Miss G. Miss G say likes the shirt there. Get your T-shirt there. Then Raul, but then what the company name again, boy? No, they don't know that. Anyway, enjoy the rest of the day and trust that everything is okay with you all and fine. For now, he said I wonder where the talk one lot of craziness on the phone telling who creates Super Button. He must drop a knock your head. That one is PG. Anyway, my name is Dylan Jones.
I not only knock your head, but knock it hard.
My name is Dylan Jones. So Emmanuel Martinez saying, have a wonderful morning. So long. God bless you. And see you soon. Bye-bye.